Okay, I'm making a super quick impromptu video about the spray gun. If you remember, about a year ago, I made a video on how to clean a Harbor Freight spray gun for the first time out of the box. Well, this is that same spray gun. And after I cleaned it, set it up, I used it to make a series of videos on painting my Ford Ranger. I sprayed Rust-Oleum through it, I sprayed epoxy primer, 2K primer, base and clear coat all through this gun, and the results were really good, but there are some quirks to this thing, and if you read reviews of this spray gun, you'll know, before I even say it, what the issues are. First of all, it was leaking paint like a sieve out here. Now there's a screw down in there that you stick a flathead screwdriver in, you turn it, it compresses the O-ring a little bit more, squishes it in so it grips the shaft a little tighter, and it stops leaking. Well, I kept doing that, the leak would come back, kept doing that, leak would come back. Eventually, last fall, I ended up taking that out. What it was, the O-ring itself was shredded. I have no idea how they managed to do that, but it was in little pieces. That's why it wouldn't seal. I went to the hardware store. I brought the needle valve with me so that way I could get an O-ring that fit. Got the O-ring. It was like 28, 29 cents. Stuck it in there. That fixed that problem. So if your spray gun is leaking out here, first you can try adjusting it by tightening the little packing nut in there with a flat tip screwdriver. If you get to the point where no matter how much you tighten it, it still leaks, go to the hardware store, 29 cents later, it won't leak paint anymore. Now, there's another issue, and this issue bugs me a lot. And that is that this is the air valve for it. When you have it in there, you got the spring, ta-da, you push it, that little tapered cone opens up and the air can go in, out the hole, up to the rest of it, and out the front. When you let go of the trigger, this spring is supposed to push this little cone back in. Now there's an O-ring inside here that is kind of tight, which is good, so you don't get air leaking out, but it's not so good in the fact that a lot of times the spring just is not strong enough to actually close the thing. So the thing goes into cruise control. You can stop the fluid flow because the fluid needle valve is totally separate and that spring has no problem closing that against the tip. So it stops spraying paint, but the air keeps going. And I've gone around that by putting a couple drops of oil on the shaft. No, it doesn't get oil in the rest of the thing because there's an O-ring in between, and I just put one drop, and that takes care of it for a while, then the stickiness comes back. So what I'm going to do for that is I got a piece of 5/16 round bar, and what I did is I cut a slice off that's an eighth of an inch thick. That was fun. And what I'm going to do is drop it down in there so this acts as a spacer at the back of the spring just to put a little more tension on the spring. So hopefully it has enough force to actually push that little cone in each time. And I've tried this a couple times, dropping it down in there. What I find is you probably can't see it on camera. I can't even really see it in real life, but when I take it under the light, it tips at an angle. So I'm just taking a brazing rod, because I happen to have one handy, and I'm just tapping it down so it sits flat in there. And with that in there, I just put this back in. Remember the little white piece of plastic? That's got to be in there. Now I'm just going to go ahead and screw this back in. There's another model of purple spray gun, slightly different shade of purple, and it's got fours in the model number instead of a six. I think this one starts with six, the other one starts with four. It doesn't have, this part is not brass, it's aluminum cast into it. It has a slightly different packing setup here, so I don't know if that one suffers the same issue this one does. I've never used it. I bought one because it was on sale for $5 and I decided to have it as a backup. This part is not nearly as nice as this one. The air cap isn't nearly as well made as this one, so I haven't actually used that one. But just be aware, there is a model floating out there that has fours in the number, and it has a different packing setup, so you might not have this issue. Probably has some other issue with spray pattern or something. Okay, let's see if we fix this thing. I just temporarily put this air fitting on because I didn't feel like going and finding either a little regulator or an air filter. So if you hear a little bit of air leaking, it's probably coming out of there. Yeah, it leaks a little bit right there. That's okay. Let's see how this does. And the time I would see it sticking the most is when I would just open it a little bit. Well, before I was so rudely interrupted by the air compressor, it was working. And normally when it would stick is if I was just opening it partway, not all the way, for doing like spot repair where I'd turn the fan down, crank the fluid needle in almost all the way so it had very little movement. That's when it used to stick. Doesn't stick anymore, so I think I solved that problem. I know I solved that problem. Now, there are going to be some people that say, well, you should just buy a high-quality spray gun and be done with it. Well, the fact of the matter is that this thing, it does a good job spraying paint. It's got some issues, like having to put spacer in, put an O-ring in, had to do quite a bit of cleaning to get all the gunk out of it originally. So, I'm not trying to say that this is a high-quality gun by any stretch of the imagination, but I'm willing to accept that I have to do a little bit of work to the thing because this was less than $10. With the added O-ring in it, it bumped it up to just over $10. So I really can't complain about it. The paint gun snobs of the world, professional painters who use this thing all the time, yes, they're going to have issue with it. For me, it does the painting I need it to do, and for the money, I kind of like playing with the insides of the paint gun.